We begin with 2 points. These are the 2 points that we are interested in finding the midpoint for, and checking, of course. To make this easier, we connect these 2 points with a line segment. Every line segment is somewhere in space, so we can draw a Cartesian grid to represent where our line segment is. Simply draw the two other sides beside the hypotenuse of a right triangle, having the right angle connecting the x and y axes. This will give a representation of the line in space, and can be used to find the midpoint based on what the halfway points of the x and y axes are, based on both points of the line. We now label the first point on our line segment as point A, and the second point as point B, logically. We label the origin of our Cartesian plane, which is only temporary because it needs to be referencing the line segment, as C. We label the midpoint between A and C as X because it is on the x-axis, and the midpoint between B and C as Y as it is on the y-axis. We now draw a square with vertices X, C, and Y, with the final vertex being labeled M, which will lay somewhere in the middle of the line segment AB. This is actually the midpoint of AB, which makes it useful in our calculations. An interesting thing you should notice at this point is that our large triangle consisting of the x-axis, y-axis, and our line segment has now been broken up into 2 triangles and a square. Triangles AMX and BMY are congruent due to the fact that the central portion of the triangle we've drawn between the x-axis, y-axis, and our line segment is a square. This means that line segments AM and BM are therefore the same length, which means that M is the midpoint of A and B, because it lies in the middle. Point A can now be labeled X1 and Y1, because it is the first point that starts out our line segment, and it lies on both the x-axis, and it is the lowest y. Point B can be labeled as Y2, and the spot where it lies on the x-axis can be labeled as x2, because this is where the point is on the y-axis and x-axis, and it is the second point on our line segment. Point X is in the middle of point x1 and x2, now that we have labeled these, which means that it is at the average of these points, or x equals x2 minus x1 over 2. Point Y lies in the middle of y2 and x2, or y1, depending on which way you look at it. For our calculations, we are concerned that it lies exactly in the middle of y2 and y1, which means that y equals y2 minus y1 over 2. The point M has an x value of x and a y value of y, which means that M is x2 minus x1 over 2, comma y2 minus y1 over 2, which is the midpoint formula. There's your explanation.